Well, here's a pretty frequent mistake. I thought I'd just do a quick little movie on this. The difference between a numerator and a denominator is a thin line, right? The numerator's the top part, the denominator's the bottom, and we put a thin line in between. That's one way of showing dividing. But this will mess you up every time if you don't realize that the numerator is calculated separately from the denominator. What do I mean? All right, let's give that a try here. Stand by. I think most people know how to do 8 divided by 2. Right? We sometimes write it as a fraction, like at 8 divided by 2. That means how many 2's can you take away repeatedly from an 8? In other words, 8 divided by 2 if you put it on a calculator. All right. So 8 divided by 2, and I hope you know that there's 4 2's in an 8. So you can take away 2 4 times. That's what dividing means. Anyway. The answer's 4. 8 divided by 2 is 4. That was easy. But, you know, it gets a bit more complicated than that. What if you get a bit more complicated, like 6 minus 4 divided by 2? Oh, now, what that means when you write it is all of 6 minus 4 divided by 2. It doesn't mean 6 subtract 4 divided by 2. It means 6 minus 4, all calculated, then divided by 2. So it means all of the top 6 minus 4, all of the numerator, divided by 2. So 6 minus 4, all calculated first, then divided by 2, sounds like it's going to be 2. Because 6 minus 4 is 2, divided by 2 will be 1. So you got 2 divided by 2 is 1. The answer is 1. 6 minus 4, all divided by 2, is 1. Here, I'll even put it on a plastic brain for you. Notice that when you put it in your plastic brain, you have to tell your plastic brain that it's the entire top is 6 minus 4. If you don't tell your plastic brain that the entire top is 6 minus 4, and you type it in wrong without the brackets, look at the weird answer you get. The only thing that gets divided by the 2 is the 4, because we always do dividing first, right? So, if you didn't put the brackets in, you get 4. When you do it properly with the brackets, by telling the plastic brain that the entire top is calculated separately from the bottom, you get the correct answer when you use brackets. So you have to put the numerator, if it's more than just a single digit, you have to put the numerator in brackets. We don't bother writing the brackets. I mean, we all know they're there, but you got to tell the calculator they're there. We just got kind of lazy as mathematicians, and we went, we know that that means the top is separate. All right, let's try another example. Let's try this one. How about if I make the bottom an expression instead of just a single number? All right, this means 6 divided by all of 4 minus 2. In other words, you got to calculate the bottom separately from the top. You always calculate the top separately and the bottom separately before you do the divide in that. So this means 6 divided by, 4 minus 2 is 2. So you know the answer is 3. So as before, the top and the bottom are calculated separately, the numerator and the denominator are calculated separately before you do the final divide. And look, you put it in the calculator like that. You have to tell the calculator that the entire bottom is the divisor or the denominator. If you don't do that, you'll get the wrong answer. You don't want this. This is not what you do. Notice if you leave out the brackets, you're going to get the wrong answer. So 6 divided by all of 4 minus 2 means 6 divided by, you calculate the 4 minus 2 first before you do the dividing. So make sure you put the brackets in. Put the entire denominator in brackets, unless it's just a single number. But anytime you got an expression or some operations going on in the bottom, you better put the entire top and the entire bottom in brackets. How about if we mix it up a bit? How about if I have 6 minus 2 all divided by 3 minus 1? So this means all of 6 minus 2 all divided by 3 minus 1. So 6 less 2 all divided by all of 3 less 1. Can you kind of see what the answer is? Isn't that 4 divided by 2? The answer should be 2, shouldn't it? Because it means you do the top separately and the bottom separately. So even though we don't have the brackets showing there, they're there. They're implied. Everybody knows they're there. So this means 6 minus 2, you calculate the top separately. You calculate the bottom separately, because you always do the contents of brackets first. Then you do the final divide. I hope you're listening to this. So it ends up being a 4 in the top, a 2 in the bottom. Then you do the final divide, 4 divided by the 2. The answer is 2. So the proper way to do 6 minus 2, or all of 6 minus 2 divided by all of 3 minus 1, is 2. And if you put it in your calculator with the brackets, the calculator has to be told that there's hidden brackets there. It gives you the right answer. So you have to tell the calculator what the numerator is and what the denominator is. You have to put in the brackets. Calculators aren't as smart as you. Right? So the brackets are implied when you write this. Implied means everybody knows they're there. Right? They're implied. We know they're there. We're not going to bother writing them if we know they're there. Why would we write something if we know that it's there? So everybody knows they're there. So just be careful. You do not type it in like this, 6 minus 2 divided by 3 minus 1. Because if you didn't put the brackets in, the only dividing that happens is the 2 gets divided by the 3. We didn't want to have the 2 divided by the 3. We wanted to have all of the 6 minus 2 divided by all of the 3 minus 1. So make sure you put in the brackets. There you go. So just always calculate the top separately from the bottom before you do the final divide. So if you've got some number plus another number divided by all of another number plus some other completely different number, it really means the top is calculated separately from the bottom. You have to fudge in the brackets. There. Let's not do those mistakes again. And just be aware, we often leave out the brackets. When we write it like that, we mean that. You have to fudge in the brackets. Complete.